You serve as role models. Your efforts and accomplishments are nothing short of amazement. Your accomplishments are also inspiring, and believe me, we all can use some inspiration. In my county of Essex, we alone have, as of May 31st, 1,001 children that did not spend last night in the care of their parents or guardians. That's a staggering number. As a judge or as a participant in this field, if that number doesn't bother you or keep you up at night, then frankly, you should be doing something else. Nationally, we have 440,000 children in out-of-home placement. I know that keeps Commissioner Milner and Mr. Kelly up at night as they work on the national level to improve our system. I thank them for their guidance, efforts, and leadership, and we're honored to have them here today. There is no more important right in our judiciary than the right of the family. Recently, our appellate division, and that's the court that sits above the trial court, in 2005, in a famous opinion that goes by the initials JEV, stated that after New Jersey eliminated the death penalty, we no longer have the death penalty, the appellate division said, quote, "We can think of no legal consequence of greater magnitude than the termination of parental rights," close quote. That is, there is no right of greater magnitude than the right to parent your child, and no consequence in our judiciary greater than the termination of parental rights. So first, let me thank all those who work day in and day out on this right of great magnitude. People who spend their professional careers helping children and families, and people who work toward and make possible days like this one, days that we're here to celebrate. I'd like to personally thank Legal Services of New Jersey on many levels for their work in our courtrooms and leadership. The Office of Parental Representation, all of the caseworkers, law guardians, DCF personnel, CASA volunteers, service providers, the Deputy Attorney Generals, our committed staff at the Administrative Office of the Courts. You all are inspiring. Now, I'd like to speak a few brief moments about the judicial perspective, what judges can do so that we have more days like this one. First, we must be patient and understanding, and we must make sure that everyone is treated with respect and dignity. That's a given. But we must make sure parents aren't overloaded with simultaneous services. We must be empathetic and understanding of the stresses and anxiety that the families are suffering from when we see them. And very important, we must make sure each parent is given tailored services. That is, specific services tailored for that parent's needs. If the state of New Jersey removes your child, you're reasonably entitled to the resources of the state to reunify you. Courts need to make sure that happens. Here we speak of reasonable efforts. Cookie cutter services don't cut it. We are all different and we all have different needs. Judges must make sure that the particular service and help directed at a particular family is for the particular needs of that family. Now, reasonable efforts can and must start before the removal of the children. Can we do something to strengthen the family? Can we do something to prevent the removal? This is part of the Family First Prevention Services Act, Judge Flory mentioned, was passed recently in 2018. And let me give you an analogy. There's lots of analogies here to explain the concept. But think of football players getting injured on the field. We all agree that's a problem. Well, the solution isn't to make better stretchers to get those players off the field. How about we make better equipment to avoid the injuries in the first place? How about we strengthen families in the first place to prevent the removal? I'm proud of the work we do in New Jersey in the area of child welfare. I have the honor of being on a national committee, and I get to meet judges from all around the country who are working the child welfare system. New Jersey is, has been, and will remain a recognized leader, but we can do more. We have to build positive relationships between resource families and biological families. We have to ensure that families are receiving meaningful, reasonable efforts and services to strengthen that family as soon as possible, up front, before a removal. And we, if we do that, we'll be able to prevent many removals and keep families together. Our courts are gatekeepers. We need to be aware of the variety of services available to parents, and we need to make sure that every effort is undertaken. And if a removal becomes necessary, we need to make sure that the family is receiving the proper, specific services needed by that family. That will ensure the likelihood of children being able to go home. Please know that those of us committed to this docket are committed to better outcomes. I ask that you all be a voice in our reforms. Each of you has a story that needs to be told and listened to. Help us so all families can experience the overwhelming joy you have experienced through unification. Again, congratulations and thank you for inspiring all of us.